So the fourth key Ashrefer, there are a number of psukim that we say from different kapitlach. It's not a united kapitel. The Rosh Tevis of it, not the opening pasuk, not the last pasuk, but the Rosh Tevis is kras sotan, tear up the sotan. If you look at kufresh ayin, samach tes nun. So there's this remez in the Rosh Tevis, the first letter of each pasuk, to negating the accuser. But the psukim themselves, as you can see, are a collection of different psukim. The kapitel before that is a kapitel, but I'm talking about the final psukim that we say, pasuk by pasuk, before the Kiyas Shofar. One of them is, Tuv, Tam Vadas Lamdeini, teach me, literally, not Stam, Tam Vadas, understanding, but the best of understanding, Kivim Mitzvei Secha Hamanti, because I believe in your mitzvahs. Hinei posuk zeh me'apsukim she'omrim oisam kedem atkiyas. This is one of the psukim we say before tkiyas. Vayachak morim v'chom yad mor. And the Fidig Rebbe explains behemshech Rosh Hashanah tov reish tzadik vov. 1936. In the psukim that we say bechlal, in the tefillah, tefillas musaf, in connection with Kiyas Shofar, yeshna bei sugim, there are two categories. The first category is psukim malchi zichlenes v'shofres. So we say there's 10 psukim in each of these themes. There's three from Torah, three from the Vim, three from Ksuvim, and then a 10th from Chumash again. So there's 10 psukim for each of the three themes of Malchias. You have it on your phone. I didn't make a photocopy. Zichonis and Shoifres. So this we say, Sh'im Nibat Tfilis U'Brochis Rosh Hashanah. We say it in the Tfilis and the Brochis. He means by the Brochis, he means they call the Gemara calls them Brochis. That of Rosh Hashanah associated all in with the bracha and they were associated with the shofar. That's one category of psukim. And then there's the second category of psukim she'omrim kedem atkiyas, the ones we spoke about earlier, the final psukim before tkiyas. Now, there's a difference between these psukim, and that is v'klolus inyan amiris psukim hu. In general, first of all, what's the meaning of the psukim? Kamay marazal, it's based on the Gemara in Rosh Hashanah. The Rabbi said, in the name of the Eibishter, as it were, Eibishter says, Imru lefanai malchiyas, say, Eibishter says to Yidden, say before me in Rosh Hashanah psukim of malchiyas, today, shetam lichuni aleichem, that in order you should make me king over you. Zichroin, they say before me psukim of zichroin, they say remembrances. Kedeshi yov, ilafanai zichroinechem letoiva, that your mention come before me for good, in good standing. And he concludes, ubambe, and how is all this affected by shofar? To the blowing of the shofar. There's two pirushim in the Gemara, the Rashi in Tosfos. Whether by shofar means the actual blowing or means also the psukim of shofars. At any rate, simple shot of the Gemara, like Rashi explains, is it means by man, how by shofar, the blowing of the shofar. As he goes on to say, even though the coronation and the drawing down of Hashem's malchus, Hashem's kingship in a new level each year, it's done through the actual blowing of shofar. We also need the psukim. He's implying here the psukim, not just of malchus and zichronos, but also the psukim of shofars. Why? Because in order that the kiyas effect, the drawing down of the Eibishter's malchus on his people Yisrael. Ba'idezeh gam al kol ha'olam, and threw them to the whole world. So why do you need the psukim? Just the actual blowing of shofar. So tzorich tchilo lahosir is kol ha'mekatregim v'ha'lomes v'ha'steirim. First, you have to remove the accusers and the coverings and the concealment. As I mentioned in the psukim directly before tkiyas, is hinted to in the first letters of each of the psukim, aside from the first and the last, there's a total of 8 psukim, and the middle 6 spell the word kras sotan, tear up the sotan. So shazeh nas al yedei amidis psukim. So this is effected through the psukim. Etc. Removing the accuser, the accusations as in asis am shocha al yedei atkiyas. So then the amshocha happens to the tkiyas. It's obvious to be pointed out that the sotan is not some, you know what, flapping black and dark devil-looking creature. The sotan is us, the Yitzhahara, our own acts, actually our own actions and words and thoughts. That's the sotan. And they come and they say, we are disgusting and ugly and he made me. We want to be fixed. Even that's somewhat metaphoric, but that's the union. Akolponim, so we can't simply just breeze into tkiyas and be mamlich the Eibishter. There's a howl of protest. Who are you? What are you doing here? So in order to break it and to remove it, we need the psukim. Now this is also into Tunigla, v'zeh ha'masha kosev ha'Rambam. The Rambam writes that Afal Pishet in Hilchas Tshuva, that Afal Pishet ki Ashreif Baruch Hashon Gzeres HaKosov, even though the blowing of Shofar is a Gzeres HaKosov, meaning to say, there's no overt reason for it. Nonetheless, Remez Yesh Bo, it has an illusion. Kloima, to say, Ur Yisheni Mishan Naschem, waken those who sleep from your sleep. Vinir Domim, and those who slumber, akitsu, arise, mital demaschem, from your slumber. It's a shrill sound that awakens. Reveille. Showing in a tshuva, that's in of tshuva, that's the remez of the Rambam, in explaining the union of shofar. But the question is, the luchura, itki ha-shofar, yinachtor, av ha-mishochas ha-malchus. What's Shuva here? Tkiyas Shofar is coronating and drawing down the Eibishter as Melech. Umaya Shaychis in Yinat Shuva. And where does Shuva, what's the connection to Shuva? The answer is as we're explaining. Achrein Yinhu. Shkidein Shakadosh Baruch Hu Kabel Sachtar Eli Yis Melech. In order that the Eibishter should accept it from me. That he should be Melech. Tzarech Li Hakdom Sat Shuva. There has to be the tshuva shemisidah as called Allah mezvestedim. It removes all the concealments and the barriers. V'yozdav kev sheli es achtorah shebi natkiyas, and then can be the coronation effected through the tkiyas. Now, that's bechlal. The beprotis, there's a profound difference between the psukim in malchis, echreinus, and shayfres, and the psukim said mamish directly before tkiyas shayfres. As he goes on to explain. We're just on the subject to address this. The embassy is how this was understood before the Rebbe explained it. I don't know. So here's the Nekudah. Everybody knows that Shabbos and Baruchim, Tishrei, we don't announce the month and bless it. What's the reason for Shabbos and Baruchim? The reason is because we instituted, because the people didn't have calendars, and to know what days is Chodesh. We announced the Moilid, etc. Then we also bench it. So why don't we do it Shabbos Avorachim Tishrei. The answer Benigel is in order to confuse the Satan. You shouldn't know when Rosh Hashanah and common cues. And there are many things we don't do for the same reason, including there's not one reference to Rosh Chodesh in Tfilas Rosh Hashanah. It's Rosh Chodesh Tishrei. No mention. To confuse him, he didn't mention Rosh Chodesh, he's not going to show up. We also blow Shofar earlier than we should. Should be really late until it's Musaf. We blow it before, like he hasn't showed up to the trial. So he comes there, done. And in case he did, he's psukim here. So the Rebbe asked the obvious question, but first of all, do we believe in a Satan like this, a Satan? Someone asked me, we believe in Satan? It's a good question. It's just so unfair. How many times do you hear the word Satan? We sure do. It's in Tanakh. The whole Eve is a whole Maisa with the Satan there. That's number one. That's the Rebbe doesn't ask that because that's obviously a given question. The question really is, I mean, how often can you fool him? You can fool him once. It's already done that 1,000 years. That every year he's fooled. He can't see a calendar. It's printed. Now we have calendars. So he's a malach. He can't see the calendar. So what does it mean? So the nekuda is saying, you know, I'm going to the hadiches. The nekuda is the satan is in here. So very nekuda is you tell a yid like this. Normally we would make a big announcement when Rosh Hashanah, the Shchedish is coming, and we bless it. Should there be a month when we do that? It's Tishrei. If there's ever a month that we should make in Shula Patch on the Bima, Shana is coming. Ta-da-da-da, and a bracha. It's what? It's Rosh Hashanah. Can't do it. Sotan. In other words, you bring your patch on the table and you're ready for Rosh Hashanah. Really? Can't wait for the moment. Big announcement, and we're benching it. There's a Satan. Who's the Satan here? It's humbling for the Yid. There's work to be done. We're not waltzing into Rosh Hashanah, you know, with the confidence of, hey, great, we're going to have chal and honey and whatever nice fruits. He's trembling. It's achtaras ha-melech. I have to be machta the melech. So there's no announcement public in terms of, you follow the point of his confidence. It's to be pale, a shvira, a bittle in the person. Not some trick to trick some satanic, who knows what. There's one Eivishter. There's no Satan in the sense that we all, you know, associated with it because of the society we live in. So then we'll soon see the Maimar also here. That it's krass Satan. That's what it says there in the Rosh Tevis of this Pesukim. It's actually tear up the Satan. So you'd sister thinking of some angel and we're tearing him up. No, it's here. The mind will give us a beautiful explanation and this how this the whole avodah. So let's continue. In the Asara Saki Trugim. Yeah, where has sorry, you have the place. It's on your phone. It's on the Chassidus app. Now he says the removal of the ketrugim of the accuser. It's primarily the psukim before tkiyas. Why? As opposed to what? As opposed to the psukim of malchis, achenis, and shofars that we say afterwards in musaf, at the end of which we also blow shofar. They're actually called the brachas. The Gemara calls the brachas of the shofar, malchis, zechernis, and shofars. But they're different. Why? Shara psukim, malchis, zechernis, and shofars, shachrat kios. Psukim that we blow after the first blowing. Shetiknum, that chazal, medivri sofim. The sofim goes way back. He had the quote earlier from Rabbi, they used to say before me, malchis, zechernis, and shofars, just a stamba ha'orah. The way we say the psukim today, it's 10 psukim, 3 from Torah and 3 Nevin, 3 from Ksuvim. And then we conclude with the Pasuk in Torah. Rabbi's saying, according to Abish, this is from Torah Shabbat Peh, goes from day one. Just to start, they didn't say the psukim that we, till Nevin was written, they didn't say the psukim. They said the Inyan. Here's Ha'orah. Now we have it laid out the way we have it. So this is all established with Divrei Sofrim from the early sages, literally the scribes. So boyim, so those psukim kam, v'hemshecho b'siyua, the tkiya shofar, they are really part of and help the blowing of the shofar, as opposed to removing kitrugim, removing barriers, protests. That's not the ikar inyan. Elsewhere, Chassidus says, Torah oir, Torah is giloy. So the inyan of the psukim, there's many levels to it, but the inyan of the psukim of Malchis, Echonis, and Shofar is the giloy of what Shofar and Achtar effects. So the other layers, in the Sinas Koyach from Torah, Torah Paskin, so you get a Koyach. But at any rate, they're affirmative, they're positive, they're not about removing Kitrugim, accusations, but about affecting the actual coronation of Hashem. In contrast, the Iker Asoras HaKitrugim, so the main removal of the accusation, Eina Al Yedei Psukim, Eil is not through the Psukim. Ela Yedei HaPsukim Shekei Matkiyas, it's the Psukim we say before Tkiyas. Sheheim Minag Bilvad. This is a Minag, I don't know where it started, but it doesn't go back to Sinai. Imru the Davis is the same before Psukim. Shehem achonet ki ha-shofar. So at a certain point, it was necessary. A minig always emerges when it's necessary. So at a certain point, it was necessary for this minig to remove a tiny accusation. And this is critical. V'davke hei, misirim misal kol ha-mesochim. And they remove all the, mesochim means all of the veils. As he says, that the Fidik Rebbe in this Maimer of Tafresh Tzadik Vov. Look, I'm ready to give a word, friends. The Vahanocha Rishoyna, the first sign, Shebnei Yisrael mis Anchim Koydent Ki Ashof, that he eats sighs before the blowing of the Shofar. Now, that's obviously not, you know, now we have to sigh. Now you have to cry. It's a side that's inescapable. It's not for now, but I'll share this with you. Most amazing kibir of the Rebbe in those unvocalized words that are said just before Tkir Shofar, in that silence and the kavona. Okay, we'll talk about the closer to Rosh Hashanah. Remind me. So says the Fidik Rebbe, that this side, it's in the spontaneous side that comes from the Neshom of a year before the Shofar is blown, Poyelim, Meiridika thing. Look at the words. This affects She'oimed Mekisei Din, that the Eibishter gets up, as it were, from the throne of judgment, the Yoshev HaKisei Rachamim, and sits on the throne of mercy. He's referring here to the shape of the Shofar that has to be dafka narrow at the mouthpiece and then wide at the end. You know, you can manipulate a shofar. If you make it soft, we can blow it the other way, mind you. You're not yotze. It has to be blown. Out of the constraints, I call upon God. So it'll be constrained and then become broad. But also, as the Medrash says, it's going from din, narrow, boxed in, out, in, to kisei rachmi. So he's saying, when a yid gives the sigh, this is the silent sigh. It's a silent sigh that comes from the neshama of Eden. So this is pearl. The Eibishter goes from din to rachmi. Shenase hasoras kol ha-kitrugim. This removes all the barriers. Now, further detail. Now we hinde yahev reshbein apsukim kodem atkis apsukim shem betfilisum. Look, Pashat, at the translation of the psukim. Look at the psukim that we say directly before Tkiyas, and the psukim of Malchis, Echernes, and Shoivis is Shabbat psukim. There, in the psukim we say during davening, the content is clear. Nisker, Malchis, and Yoni, Malchis, Echernes, and Shoivis, all the psukim that are woven together, all unified themes, and they're all consistent, and each pasuk stands and says what it says, and it's all woven. Three themes, Malchias, Echonis, and Shofar. Shekim, Absukim, Shekim, Matkias, Shofar. Number one, the Pesukim before Tkiyas Shofar, Ein Bem Shum Askara Mi Tkiyas Shofar Klal. There's no mention of Shofar at all. The last one does, but that's not part really, that's an intro and a conclusion. It's not part of the body of the Kara Sotan. Olalikim Bisuah Hashem Bakel Shofar. The Pesukim, the body of these Pesukim, has no mention of Tkiyas Shofar. Become market. So the question is kind of asking, so how are these psukim are the psukim that remove all the kitrugim? He says dafke, yeah, become mokim, dafke yodim nasya sachon tkiya shayfer, is dafke through them that achon fit kiya shayfer lohasu kala masochim to remove all the veils. Okay, I guess we'll continue tomorrow.